By 1993, 23-year-old Mariah Carey had taken a childhood dream of becoming a singer-songwriter and translated it into stardom. After marrying her mentor, Tommy Mottola, Mariah released her third album, recorded from an appearance on MTV's Unplugged.
Unplugged was like my first concert, pretty much. And I was nervous because I wasn't like from the performer side of things. I came more from like the studio production backup singer world.
Mariah's appearance on Unplugged garnered yet another number one single from her cover of the Jackson 5 song I'll Be There with Trey Lorenz. Yet there were lingering doubts about whether the virtuoso talent was merely a studio creation. When she released her fourth album, Music Box, in September of 1993, Mariah decided it was time to finally go out on tour, and the critics sharpened their pencils in anticipation.
First show got horrible reviews in Miami, and I remember I was sitting and watching CNN, and they were like, well, the reviews are in and it's not great for Mariah's tour. And I was like, they care about this on CNN? Like, what is this? And it got me really mad. So then I went and did the show in Boston, and I just took all that energy and put it into the show. Just like this really amazing review, because what I did is just let go of all my inhibitions and just really put the energy into the audience and getting feedback from the audience. And that's when I realized that that's what it's about. Like, stop holding back, being, you know, inhibited, and just do you.
Music Box went on to become Mariah's best-selling album, earning her two additional number one singles, Hero and Dream Lover. It was apparent that no matter what the critics thought, her fans were crazy about her.
I can't think of one person that unanimously is like, you know, has everybody in the world loving them and living for them. That's an unrealistic goal. So I just look at it like, I'm gonna make myself happy and I'm gonna make my fans happy because they're the ones who matter.
Nobody embraces their fans like Mariah. I've seen her break away from security and run across a soaking wet parking lot while it's raining in a full-length white beaded gown to say hello and shake hands and stuff through the fence.
Well, I think the key to Mariah's success socially is this relatability. I think there are a lot of, especially young girls out there, that just relate to her. And she's the kind of woman that men just love.
In 1992, Mariah made a commitment not only to her fans, but to underprivileged youth when she began a relationship with the Fresh Air Fund in New York, founding Camp Mariah.
The Fresh Air Fund sends New York City children out of the city in the summertime, and we're actually very old. We've been doing this for 125 years. We were building a new camp in Fishkill in the early 90s, and we were looking for somebody to be our angel, and Mariah was interested in building a camp.
My camp is a career awareness camp, because if they don't really have role models within their own community or people that they know within their family, they meet different. I try to bring up different people that are successful that aren't just like the star.
Mariah is wonderful with the kids. I mean, she will just say, get rid of the adults here, you know, I'm just going to talk to the kids. And she really has an ability to focus no matter what is going on around her.
In 1994, Mariah found another creative focus when she directed the music video for Fantasy, the first single from her sixth album, Daydream.
I would have rather been able to work with like Herb Ritts or one of the directors that I really wanted to work with, but there was this concern that they would make me look too sexy. And I was like, okay, whatever. I guess that's all right for everybody else, but not me. So I'll direct the video.
The other thing is a good transition. I was just thinking of something to start the whole thing.
Okay.
And have him introducing exactly the whole thing.
But
he opens the hat, and then he does the motion to take the rest of the park thing.
And that takes the camera to see the skate, all the skating.
Right.
Okay, fine, no problem.
It's the opening shot.
She understands the process. And when you have somebody who understands the process of either directing a video or being involved in a shoot, it just makes the whole thing go smoother.
Remix.
my favorite part was filming ODB and having the clown tied up. Filming him doing that, it was really fun just seeing, you know, just watching somebody else perform and being there and asking, you know, to do the things.
That was a huge record. Fantasy, it was huge.
Me and Mariah. Like babies with pacifiers.
Babies with pacifiers.
That's right. It was like something that a lot of people who see me will just say it to me on the street, and I'm like, yep.
The triumph of Daydream put Mariah Carey in a league of her own. By now, her six best-selling albums had sold over 70 million copies worldwide, and she'd been honored with 2 Grammy Awards, 6 American Music Awards, 7 Billboard Awards, and 6 World Music Awards for her achievements.
Thank you very much.
Yet 26-year-old Mariah remained unimpressed with her own success.
Doing that record was fun for me, and so it wasn't like, oh, this has to be... I have to make, you know, the biggest hits and da-da-da. I was just making songs that I liked, you know what I mean? And so, you know, having them be successful was just added extra, you know, icing on the cake.
Next, Mariah discovers that butterflies must be free.
I guess I didn't let myself hope in terms of happiness or freedom because I just didn't think it would ever happen.
And later, the press pushes her too far.
She shouldn't even, you know, read any of those things.
When life